वेलकम ऑल इन लेक्चर 4 ऑन इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक थ्योरी। इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट सिलेंड्रिकल कोऑर्डिनेट सिस्टम। वी विल आल्सो डिस्कस अबाउट कन्वर्जन ऑफ पॉइंट एंड वेक्टर फ्रॉम सिलेंड्रिकल टू कार्टेशियन कोऑर्डिनेट सिस्टम एंड वाइस वर्सा। इन सिलेंड्रिकल कोऑर्डिनेट सिस्टम the location of point P is represented by three axes which are r, phi and z axes. Again r, phi and z axes are mutually perpendicular to each other. So the location of a vector in cylindrical coordinate can be represented as vector OP is r, r cap plus phi, phi cap plus z, z cap. In cylindrical coordinates, point P lies on the surface of a cylinder. The minimum distance from z axis to point P is called r distance. If we draw a perpendicular from point P on x axis, it will cut axis at point N. So distance from P to point N is called Z distance. Now if we connect origin with N, then x axis will make angle phi with ON. So this angle is called phi. So we represent point P by three points which are r, phi and z. So r here is the minimum distance from z axis to point P, z distance is from origin to point P, this distance, and phi angle is the angle between x axis and vector ON. So from this we can note that the z axis in Cartesian and cylindrical coordinate system remains the same. It is r axis and phi axis which is different from x axis and y axis in Cartesian coordinate system. So if we draw a perpendicular from point P on xy plane, it will cut xy plane at point P1. So again this distance OP1 will be r distance. So vector in r direction, that is vector along OP1, is called vector r, and the unit vector along r direction is r cap. So from our previous discussion we can note it that the plane of r cap is xy plane, that is r cap lies in xy plane because vector r is in xy plane. So r cap again lies in xy plane. Now vector OP1 makes angle phi with x axis. Now when phi is 0, OP1 lies on x axis, and when phi is 90, then OP1 lies on y axis. That is phi is increasing from x axis to y axis. So the direction of phi axis is from x to y axis. Further, the phi axis should be perpendicular to r axis and it should be perpendicular to z axis. So if we draw these three axes of cylindrical coordinates, so they will be as shown in the slide. So this is z axis, this is phi axis and this is r axis. Phi axis and our axis lies in xy plane, which is perpendicular to z axis. The mutual angle between r, z and phi axis here is 90 degree. Now if we draw these three axes at the origin, they will look like, that is z axis in Cartesian and cylindrical coordinate is same. This is x axis and y axis in Cartesian coordinate system. This is r axis and this is phi axis in cylindrical coordinate system. So from here we can see that the r axis was making an angle phi with x axis. Angle between r axis and phi was 90 degree. So from here we can see that the various angles between various axes, for example, angle between r axis and x axis is phi, angle between r axis and y axis is again 90 minus 5. So angle between y axis and r axis, this angle is 90 minus 5, and angle between r axis and z axis is 90 degree. Similarly, angle between phi axis and x axis will be that in case of phi, this angle is phi, this angle between r cap and x cap is phi, angle between r cap and phi cap is 90 degree, r cap and phi cap again lies in xy plane, so angle between x axis and phi axis is 90 plus theta. Similarly, angle between phi cap and y cap, this is y cap, this is phi cap. So we can see that the angle between phi cap and y cap is phi, and angle between phi cap and z cap is 90 degree because phi cap lies in xy plane. So now is conversion of point from cylindrical to Cartesian coordinates. For example, let us suppose point P is given in cylindrical coordinates given by r, phi and z. So we know that this distance is z, this distance is r, this r makes angle phi with x axis. So from here we can find that distance x in Cartesian coordinates will come out to be r cos of phi. Similarly, distance y will come out to be r sine of phi, and z is same as in case of cylindrical and Cartesian coordinates, that is z is equal to z. From these expressions we can find that r square is equal to x square plus y square, and dividing y by x we obtain tangent of phi. After that, there is conversion of vector from cylindrical to Cartesian coordinates. For example, vector OP is given as r, r cap, phi, phi cap plus z, z cap. Now if we have to find what is projection of vector OP along x axis, the projection of vector OP along x axis can be obtained by taking dot product of vector OP in cylindrical coordinates with x cap, that is along which we have to find the projection of OP. So इफ OP इज गिवन इन सिलेंड्रिकल कोऑर्डिनेट्स एंड OP इज गिवन एज आर आर कैप प्लस फाइव फाई कैप प्लस जेड जेड कैप देन इट्स प्रोजेक्शन ऑन एक्स एक्सिस विल बी वेक्टर OP डैश डॉट एक्स कैप और OP x is equal to op dot x cap which is r r cap plus phi phi cap plus z z dash dot x cap or if it is expanded we obtain that it is r r cap dot x cap phi phi dot dot x cap plus z z cap dot x cap we have already find what is r dot that x cap r dot r cap dot x cap is cos of phi because r cap as well as x cap is unit vector and angle between them is phi so it is r cos of phi plus phi again phi cap and x cap is unit vector and angle between them is cos of 90 plus phi plus z cos of 90 degree so we obtain that projection of vector OP along x axis is r cos phi minus phi sin phi in a similar way we can find projection of vector OP given in cylindrical coordinates along y axis which is OP vector OP dot y cap or it is r r cap plus phi phi cap plus z z cap dot y cap so if it is expanded we know the value of r dot r r cap dot y cap we know the value of phi cap dot y cap we know the value of z cap dot y cap so we obtain that projection of OP given in cylindrical coordinate on y axis is r sin phi plus phi cos phi similarly we can find the projection of vector op along z axis by taking dot product of op along z cap so if we find that r dot r cap dot z cap is 90 degree phi cap dot z cap is again 90 degree so z cap dot z cap is 1 so it is opz is z that is in cylindrical as well as cartesian coordinates value of z is same so this was about the brief introduction about the cylindrical coordinates and conversion of point and vector from cylindrical to cartesian and vice versa. Thank you.